Welcome to the High Voltage Light Electric Vehicle channel. One of the biggest events of the year for bikes and e-bikes is Eurobike in Frankfurt. This year I knew someone who was going, so I got them to check out a few things that I was interested in. This is a quick video to take a look at two of those. This is the Pinion E-Drive, electronic gearbox and motor system combined. Essentially though, it's a derailleur replacement. It takes the gears from the back of the bike and puts them in the middle, and then drives the rear wheel with a belt drive or a chain drive to a single sprocket. They claim this is up to 12 gears with smooth electronic shifting under load and a full power motor. I'm not quite sure what that means though. I think the price with this is going to be massive. The rumour is that it's more than $2,500. The thing about derailleur replacements is that they're not going up against something that's crap. They're not trying to fix a problem that really exists in the world. It's not like people have huge issues shifting gears with their bikes and spend all day lamenting having to use a derailleur. The rear derailleur is something that's been refined for over 100 years. There have been lots of attempts to try and offer something different, and they've generally failed because the current system is cheap, easy to repair, easy to maintain, and does a good job. So in order for this to be a success, it has to offer something more than just function. It has to be more responsive, nicer to use, easier to maintain than what exists. Improvements even in one or two of these would be a benefit, but I hope it's more than just easier to maintain. If it manages to make changing gear seamless and almost without thought, for example. How much power can this run when it comes to shifting under load? They do say you can shift under load. It's probably going to be fine at 250 watts, but what about more than that? What if there was significant weight and loading? What I really like with this system is that it puts all the weight right in the middle. The demo bike likely has a really great center of mass. For me, this is definitely one of the most exciting things from Eurobike. Let me know what you think though in the comments. The next item is from Bafang. And after eons of waiting, Bafang looked like they finally put a torque sensor in the BBS HD. It's possibly like the lowest key introduction ever though. Apparently, it was not even on show at Bafang's own stand. The photo, which is all I have, comes from a third-party vendor, and that's it. Just the one bike with a tiny orange sign denoting the new motor and the fact that it's torque sensing. I know it's not a typo though, because my friend at the Bafang factory in Poland did confirm its existence as well. But that's all I have on it though. There have been a few rumours that it would be called the M635, but apparently it's using the BBS HD style casing and not the M65 casing. So perhaps that means they put the M65 idea out to pasture. So that leaves lots of questions as to how they're implementing it. The main one for me being, is it CAN bus or UART? And if we're lucky, they will stop using the CAN bus stuff and leave us with UART, which will mean everyone can do their own thing. On the other hand, this is Bafang we're talking about here, so they could just as likely enforce you to buy their Make You Smile battery. If I had to guess, I would say that for the time being, this company maybe has some kind of exclusive on it, and perhaps that's why Bafang are not showing it themselves. If anyone has information on this, post in the comments or jump on the BBS HD chat and Discord. Overall, the mood at the show apparently was quite downbeat. The post-COVID hangover, I guess. I think maybe some companies that were making gravy are now facing tighter times. The bottom has dropped out of the resale market, at least where I am, and there seems to be less cash going around now. By the sounds of it, all the companies are chasing after the main market sector and not really being brave enough to really push the envelope as to what's possible. I can only begin to imagine myself, though, how much more the industry could explode and how much more innovation would be done if the rules framework was changed to allow for vehicles of up to 3 kilowatts. Because then you can really start moving cargo. Having to meet 250 watts, from what I've seen, is a real stranglehold on the development of light electric vehicles. 3 kilowatts is not an insane amount to move a load of cargo in a hilly town, but cargo bike manufacturers are hamstrung. I'm going to do another video on the cargo bike side of things, as there were lots of them in the show, and some really great innovation going on there. If you want to chat about any of this stuff, especially if you've made it to Eurobike yourself, please post in the comments or on Discord. I'm going to leave it here with this one. Thanks for watching. A huge thanks to all of the channel members. Really appreciate your support. And I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.